the Cyens Weekly, an industry pundit podcast about the tech and innovation of the 21st century. An open discussion between industry experts to uncover how emerging technologies can help solve current societal issues.
Today we have with us Maria Markidou Georgiadou. Maria, you're the Managing Director of Cyprus Seeds. Please tell us a little bit about yourself and walk us through the journey of how Cyprus Seeds became what was realized from an idea to what is now a successful organization.
Thank you very much for the invitation. Thank you for giving us the opportunity to talk about this initiative, which in my opinion is unique for Cyprus. Yes, Cyprus Seeds is an initiative that was launched 3 years ago with the objective to commercialize academic innovative research that brings solutions to world problems. Myself, I undertook the responsibility of designing it first. That was actually an initiative of the University of Cyprus. If I were to go back 4 years ago, I was invited to design a program which will support the most talented Cypriots in universities, research centers, centers of excellence, to take their innovative research from the lab to the market. And therefore, in order to design the program, I was housed at the University of Cyprus for about a year, and in collaboration with the MIT and some Greeks and Cypriots of the diaspora in Boston, we put together Cyprus Seeds, because we had an inspiration ourselves in designing Cyprus Seeds, a similar program that is being done in MIT for the last 20 years with great success. Having that in mind, we needed to customize it to the requirements of Cyprus. So I did one whole year looking to customize a successful program by talking with the university professors, the researchers, the management of the universities, and finally we brought Cyprus Seeds to life. Once we launched it in November in 2019, I was appointed managing director, and then the next thing was to register a non-profit company to implement the program in Cyprus. So we gave birth to a non-profit, and then The biggest challenge that I had to face at the beginning of Cyprus Seeds was to attract the attention of organizations and foundations and individuals who shared the vision of the man who had the initial idea of Cyprus Seeds, and that man is Mr. George David from the Leventis and David families. Then Mr. David was the deputy chairman of the Council of the University of Cyprus. Then he became the chairman. And it was his idea, his vision, to introduce to Cyprus Cyprus Seeds. So beyond Mr. David, who contributed financially as well at the beginning, we needed to attract more people to give money. And I'm talking about donations. So that's not an easy task. So we needed to attract donations enough to have money to give to the very best who were to be joining Cyprus Seeds. And that's how we brought in the Hellenic Initiative. And what is the Hellenic Initiative? The Hellenic Initiative is a non-profit organization in the US. It was registered in 2012 by Greeks and Cypriots of the diaspora in the US, who wanted to give back to their countries, to Greece and Cyprus, who wanted to help Greece and Cyprus because of the crisis, economic crisis, the then economic crisis. So they thought one way about it was to create entrepreneurship, to support the youth, to support the creation of startups, and by so doing, to give opportunities for employment, and to also bring back the talented youth who left Greece and Cyprus back to their countries. So when we introduced Cyprus Seeds to them, when I was called in New York to go and present Cyprus Seeds, they thought that this was one way about it for Cyprus. And so for the last 3 years, I'm very proud to say, not only did we attract the Cypriots and the Greeks of the diaspora from the US to support us the first year of Cyprus Seeds, this is the third year they have decided to continue to give us a donation. So Hellenic Initiative, the Levantis Foundation, right from the beginning, and then who else joined forces? Eurobank, EY Cyprus, and some individuals who live in the US, in Switzerland, in the UK, and they thought that this initiative is great and let's support it in order to support its vision. So we began with donations from these individuals and foundations I have mentioned. Not only, I am sorry if I cannot name a few who would like to be anonymous. And once we had money, we announced a call to invite applications from all the universities of Cyprus, because even though the University of Cyprus was leading the idea of introducing such a program, it was said from the beginning that the program would be national, it would be for everybody. So we invited applications during the very first cycle from all the universities. And it was not a surprise that we had from the first cycle, from all the universities almost, a total of 38 applications, sorry. So, and those 38 applications, we had to assess and select five or six. That's how we do every cycle. We choose five or six who rank very highly following the assessment from foreign evaluators and those we support every year. I don't know if I have answered your question. You have fully answered. We are now in the second cycle.
This is, first of all, congratulations on the first cycle being successful, and then for running the second one. You've mentioned that, of course, the beginning is always the most difficult, and attracting funding as well. Since you've already covered the part about actually getting the funding together, how easy, let's say, was it to engage with the locals so that they understand the whole concept of Cyprus Seeds? Because you brought this here, it was a new concept. Yes, okay, we had the University of Cyprus, but then how easy was to engage with everyone else?
Thank you for the question. It was challenging. I was also worried at the beginning myself, because, you know, we had to actually compete in a certain way with other programs, like the European programs, the national programs, and to convince people that this is a worthy program, because it was, you know, one day you wake up and you hear Cyprus Seeds announcing a call for applications. Who are they? So in order to overcome this, I must admit, I did a lot of, you know, visiting to the various universities and talking to them about Cyprus Seeds and telling them the uniqueness of this initiative. And it is a unique initiative. I'll tell you why. Firstly, because it is a national initiative on the ground. It's here. It's not European Union inviting professors or whoever from Cyprus and other member countries to apply. We're here, present. They can see who is behind. And believe me, the most important thing is the team in any initiative. Secondly, we are unique. Why? Because we are focused. We are really focused in one thing, and that's the commercialization of research. And there is a gap here in Cyprus. A lot of people say that. It's not only me. There is a serious gap, because there is a lot of funding that supports research, but if you think how many programs support the commercialization of research, there aren't that many. So the fact that we are focused on this helps to have applications. Thirdly, it is unique because in implementing it, we are engaging evaluators from abroad and mentors, once we select the teams, to mentor our teams, and they are all offering their services pro bono. Pro bono. You can imagine Americans who have done commercialization before, they succeeded, and they are now investors in startups, to be offering on a regular basis their time pro bono, and that's what it is. It's all about giving back.
This podcast is brought to you by Cyens, former RISE, the Research Center of Excellence in Cyprus, focusing on interactive media, smart systems, and emerging technologies. For more information, please check our website on cyens.org.cy.